Hello everyone, my name is Saurabh Sharma. In this particular video, I am going to discuss what is inter-process communication in operating system, right? Inter-process communication, also known as a IPC. IPC is what? Inter-process communication. What is meaning by this particular methodology or is a mechanism? It is a kind of a mechanism that helps the processes in order to communicate efficiently or easily. Which process needs this communication? As we already discussed, there are two types of processes in any operating system. First one is independent process and second one is corporative process. Independent processes are what? That do not share anything. Anything means any resources with other processes. That is why they do not need any communication. That is very obvious thing. Because I have what are the resources I need, then what is the need of communicating with other? Clear? There is no need to do. It executed by the CPU independently. So IPC is not for independent processes. They are meant for the corporative processes. Right? Which is very important. In a corporative processes, we also discuss the concept of multi-programming. What multi-programming says, we need to store as many processes in a main memory as possible. And if we are storing more than one process and they are storing some data, they are sharing some data, then there should be a proper efficient mechanism between them that help them to communicate. So that our system throughput will be increased. This is our goal, right? So this is a very, very efficient mechanism. It has two models. First one is memory sharing. Memory shared, you can also say memory shared. And second one is message passing. Message passing, right? These two models are used in an IPC. First, we will discuss what is memory shared and what is message passing and which one is suitable for which kind of operating system. So, let's discuss the first one. Suppose this is your memory block, or you can say this is your kernel part. Kernel is residing in this particular block, right? And in this part there is a process P1, and this is shared memory space. Actually, what we do, we create a pool between the process, or you can say in a main memory, we design a pool in which if P1 wants to communicate to the P2, suppose P1 wants to communicate to the P2, it cannot directly communicate. So what it will do, it will simply write its message inside the memory space. Clear? This is shared memory and the P1 stored or write the message. This term is known as write. Clear? Storing its message is known as a write. This is very important. Keep this in mind. P1 write the message inside the shared memory, right? And in the shared memory, P2 go there and retrieve that message through the read operation. This is through the read operation. Clear? So that is how kernel is not interacting with the processes. Right? So that is how the communication is done in the shared memory. Clear? So in the shared memory, what we do, we simply provide the pool, or we can provide the shared space in which processes write the data if they want to send a message and if somebody is want to receive the message, he will simply read that particular message. Clear? This is all about the shared memory. Now we will discuss the message passing. Same example, same diagram. This is your P1, this is your P2, and this part is dedicated to the kernel. I hope you already know this kernel is. Kernel is what? It is a heart of a operating system which take the all responsibilities in the behalf of operating system. You can consider this part as an operating system here. Clear? So this is P1 and P2. Suppose P1 wants to communicate with the P2, what P1 do? P1 simply ask kernel, send its message to the kernel. And kernel is doing what? Kernel is maintaining a message queue. Right? Kernel is maintaining a message queue in which it is storing the message. It is a kind of a buffer and it send it message. This in this particular model, message passing. In a message passing, what we call this term as a send. So there is a no communication between direct, there is no communication. And if the P2 wants to retrieve that message, what P2 do? P2 go inside the message queue and retrieve that particular message. Retrieve or receive. Clear? This is not clear to you. Retrieve that message from the message queue. Until the message is not retrieved, message is stored inside the message queue. Once the message is retrieved by the process P2, kernel automatically delete that particular message. This is the concept of message passing, and we already discussed what is the concept of shared memory. And these two models are very important in respective to the inter-process communication. So there is a question, which one is faster in between these two? Because there is a interaction of a kernel, so it is pretty obvious this will not going to be that much. So this model is not that much fast, but both model are used in an operating system in their different scenario. Mostly we use this type of IPC communication, right? So this is all about the inter-process communication. I hope you understand this concept. Keep watching, keep learning. Do not forget to give your genuine feedback in the comments.